forced to run. I'm gonna take all the cigarettes.
My first one, I was at work. Last day, it turned out. Behind the counter.
St. John, you there? It's O'Brien.
Hold on. O'Brien, I'm sick of doing your dirty work. You got news for me or not?
Yeah, I mean, yes, I have news.
Well, then what is it?
I need you to do one last job.
Were you listening to what I was just saying? I'm done with
this. One more job, then I'll meet you in person, show you what I got.
Forget it.
Her middle name. It was Irene. Right? Sarah Irene Whitaker? It's on her admission form.
One last job.
One last job. I sent you the coordinates. O'Brien out.
Hey.
Hey. You're headed somewhere in a hurry?
Yeah. You remember that Nero bastard I told you about, O'Brien? Well, it looks like he's got some news for me, but I gotta do one last job for him first.
Yeah. Okay.
You should come with me.
Yeah? Nah, Skizzle's got me on farm duty. Feeding the world one shitty weed at a time.
Fuck Skiz, I'll drop you off right afterward. When's the last time you saw a helicopter?
I'll tell him he twisted my arm.
Never gets old, does it?
Where are we headed?
Over toward Malacqua Lake. You know where that is?
Yeah, it's just north of the Rogue Tunnel off Waldo Road. So what are we doing there?
A Nero chopper's gonna be on the ground doing whatever the hell it is that they do. O'Brien wants me to see what they're up to.
So O'Brien, he's what? Your shot caller? Handler?
Ow! Jesus, Boozer. You know why the hell we're out here.
Just asking. Seems like he tells you to jump, you ask how high.
It's not how it is. So how you holding up?
Not bad. It's been worse, you know. I actually don't mind working the farm, pulling weeds and shit. Reminds me of when I was a kid. I used to go out to my uncle's farm out at by Adrian on the Idaho border. Spend summers working the beet fields. Yeah, a little dirt bike I'd tool around on. That's where I learned to ride.
If you're not careful, I'm gonna start calling you Farmer Bill.
Get to that site, stay close. Whatever happens,
Don't let him see you. They can get a little trigger happy.
Okay, okay, got it. Stay down, keep my mouth shut, don't get us killed. Hey, thanks for bringing me along, Deke. It's good to get out again. Even riding bitch, you know?
Yeah.
Right behind you.
I haven't heard that for a while.
Yeah.
There it is.
Squad, check in.
Jesus. Never thought I'd see one of those again. In the air, I mean.
All right, now watch. Soldiers come out first, they secure the LZ. And their boy genius, researcher, scientist, whatever the hell. He comes out, he looks around.
To do what?
Whatever science shit they're doing out here. How the hell would I know?
You're the one who's been spying on them.
Okay, wait here.
You got it.
Samples.
You mean shit?
Yes.
Freak shit?
Yes.
So, we're out here in the middle of nowhere, so you can pick up freak shit.
Precisely.
Okay. Enough said.
Field note 2102. After analysis of scat samples from zones 2, 3, and 4B, there's clear evidence of Claytonia perfoliata.
What's that?
Commonly known as miner's lettuce. Please don't interrupt. As well as vinaceous berries from Juniperus communis.
So, why do we care?
Why do we care? Because it means the freaks are eating more than just us and each other. They're eating berries, plants, grass, needles, basically.
Samples. You mean shit?
Yes.
Freak shit?
Yes.
So, we're out here in the middle of nowhere, so you can pick up freak shit.
Precisely.
Okay. Enough said.
Field note 2102. After analysis of scat samples from zones 2, 3, and clear evidence of Claytonia perfoliata.
What's that?
Commonly known as miner's lettuce. Please don't interrupt. As well as vinaceous berries from Juniperus communis.
So, why do we care?
Why do we care? Because it means the freaks are eating more than just us and each other. They're eating berries, plants, grass, needles, basically anything a deer would eat. They're omnivores, just like us, but with stomachs that can digest a much wider range of cellulose.
Yeah, okay. And what?
It means they're not gonna starve when they run out of us to eat. Freaks freaks aren't going away anytime soon.
Shit. That's bad.
Yeah, that's bad. I'm done here.
Okay. Head back to the bike.
You catch any of that over my radio?
That's pretty fucked up. Good taxpayer money and they're out here collecting freaker shit.
Yeah, I told you. Who knows what they're doing or why?
Oh, they gotta have a base around here somewhere, right? You try following them?
Yeah, but they always disappear over the mountains heading south. And with the highway choked off, I can never get close.
Sons of bitches. Seems like they got a lot to answer for.
Yeah.
Where are we headed now?
It's a good question. O'Brien, are you there? Come in, O'Brien.
I'm here. Finished?
Yeah, it's done. Where am I meeting you?
I wasn't expecting you so soon. I'm sending you the coordinates now, but it might take a few minutes to get there. O'Brien out.
What the hell does he think I've been doing out here?
Hey, you're right about one thing. He does sound like an asshole.
Wait here. I don't want him getting skittish because I brought someone along.
Yeah, I'll keep an eye on the bike. I've seen enough Nero assholes for one day.
Okay, I'll be back. O'Brien said he had news. He knew her middle name, Irene. She can't be alive. But he's alive. Why not her, huh? There he is.
Yo.
Shit. You've got to stop doing that.
What you got?
All right, look. I'm going to lay it out for you, but it's not good news. I finally found a guy who was willing to do some digging through some files that they used to keep while they still kept records.
Okay, O'Brien.
Anyway, Sarah Whitaker, your wife, was admitted to the Camp MASH unit on the South Flats outside of Silver Lake. According to the records, she was in surgery for 6 hours and then was moved
okay,
to...
Okay, so she survived. The stab wound, she survived.
Yeah. According to the records, she made a full recovery. And then she was moved to another camp on the outskirts
okay,
of Tumult.
Okay, so she could still be alive. Even after all this time, she could still be alive, you're saying?
No.
What do you mean, no?
It was overrun. Everything was overrun. There were no survivors.
You survived? They survived.
Look, there was nothing that would have protected that camp, okay? Highway 97 is an artery. Infected freaks poured up from L.A., from the Bay Area, from Sacramento. There were thousands and thousands and thousands of them. There was nothing we could do.
I get it. So you bugged out. Who did you bring with you?
Nero, personnel, some feds, people with clearance.
Nero, personnel, the soldiers, the guys with the guns? The guys that should have been protecting the civilians?
There's nothing that you can do against a horde. They're too strong.
I know all about hordes.
Well, they know that there was nothing that we could do.
Oh, you know what you could have done? You could have brought a few of them with you. You could have saved a few lives.
There was no hope. There was no time. There was no room, okay? We'd already turned on each other by the time the hordes arrived.
No, I get it.
I'm sorry about your wife. I'm sorry about all of this. But you gotta understand. If you hadn't sent her with me that night, she would have been dead the next morning. You did the right thing. You know, if you had decided to stay, the only thing that would have happened is you'd be dead right alongside her.
Don't you think I know that? O'Brien. Thank you for saving her life that night.
So you're sorry.
Is that it, O'Brien? You're sorry?
Oh, damn it. All things are wasting my goddamn time.
Oh, what the hell? Boozer? Boozer?
Oh, God damn it, Boozman, where the hell did you go? Ah, shit.
Right. Boozman, where the hell did you go? Boot tracks. That's gotta be his.
Gotta take a closer look. What the hell is this? All right, what have we got?
This way.
Deke, you still there? This is Ricky. Deke and St. John.
Yeah, Ricky, I'm here. What's up?
Schizo's been asking for you. Said Boozer never showed up for his work duty. I was worried.
No, look, we're fine. We just had some stuff that we needed to get done. Tell Schizo we'll be back in an hour.
Okay. Hey, I'm almost ready to head back out there and fix that transformer. You still in?
Yeah. Yeah, just, great. Let me know when.
I can feel that hot water now. I'm gonna let that shower run forever.
Yeah, okay. It sounds great. Listen, Ricky, I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
Okay, let's see. What's going on here? There you are.
Deke, in here. Deke, over here.
Oh, Jesus, Boozer, what the hell?
I figured I'd do a little shopping while we were out, and I ran into a pack of rippers hunting dogs. Oh, easy, fella. He's not infected. He's just a dog. They're hunting down and killing healthy dogs. No, no, we can't. We can't leave him here, Deke. We can't. We can't do it.
Here. Let me do it.
Really? You can.
Okay, boy. Okay, easy. It's okay. All right, just...
Oh, Jesus, Deke. God damn it. It's okay.
Just... That's it. All right.
It's okay, big guy.
Rest.
We're one mind. You ready?
Oh, yeah, brother. I'm ready.
Man, come. I see you running around.
They are free. Free. They are free. Bring him low.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I think that's the last of them.
Oh, you sound disappointed.
Well, I hate those sons of bitches, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, come on. Let's get the hell out of here. So what the hell happened back there? You seem sort of, I don't know, like you lost it.
I don't know. I guess I needed some payback for this shit. But, there's never gonna be enough payback, is there? You know? If you had made this shit for me, you know, my arm, I mean, I don't know where I'd be. I mean, I guess I'd... Well, hell. You know.
Are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, not like I got a choice. Not like any of us do, right?
Yeah, okay, come on.
Hey, there's your bike. Hey, how'd it go?
How'd what go?
You know, goddamn wall. Your guy in the spacesuit, what'd he say?
It doesn't matter.
Hey, come on, goddamn it.
You really don't want to be doing that right now.
Oh, yeah? You think I need more than this to take down your scrawny little ass? Come on, what'd he say?
Drop it.
Seriously, what happened to Sarah? Huh? Where's your old lady?
Where's your old fucking...
Huh? Stay down, brother. Had enough? Where's your old lady, Deke?
She's dead, Boozer. Sarah's dead.
Yeah, and she's been dead a long time, so don't you think that you mourned her long enough?
Oh, God. I think that you have a hell of a left hook, asshole. Oh.
Yeah, it's the only move I got. Come on, man.
Fuck.
Oh, jeez. I gotta get my sorry ass back to work. Camp ain't gonna feed itself.
Okay.
Yeah. It's the only move I got. Still, I tagged your ass with it 3 times in a row.
Fucking shameful.
Where are we headed?
Back to camp.
No. I still gotta work a shift. Give me a ride up there. It's just north of Sherman's camp.
Okay.
So, she died that night, and there was nothing you or anyone could have done about it.
I should have been there.
And what good would that have done?
Just drop it, it's done. Skizzo, you there? Lost Lake Camp, Skizzo.
Yeah, what's up?
We just had a run-in with some...
Hey, where the hell is you, bro? He skipped work duty today. What the hell, man?
Shut up and listen to me. I was giving him a ride to the work site, and we were attacked by Rippers.
Oh, Jesus. Where?
Outside of Rogue Camp. You gotta tell Iron Mike. Carlos is coming, and he is not going to stop.
What do you think I've been telling? For months? Yeah, I'll let him know.
We're heading toward Tumalo now. Boozer will be at the site in a few minutes.
Well, that's great, because he owes the camp another half shift for the work he's missed.
Shut up, Skizzo.
Hey, Deke, Rogue Camp is kind of in the opposite direction of Tumalo, isn't it?
We took the scenic route out.
Asshole.
Goddamn, Skizzo.
Come on, you guys. Come on, keep working. Keep at it. We don't work, we don't eat.
Right already.
That's it.
Hey. Thanks for the ride.
You all starve. There you go.
St. John at Lost Lake Camp. Come back.
Deke, I hear you.
Mike.
Good.
Look, Boozer and I, we just had a run-in with Rippers.
Rippers? God damn it, you boys crossed the Iron Ridge? Deke, I told you!
Just listen. No, Mike. They were here, in Rogue Camp.
Rogue Camp? There were Rippers in Rogue Camp? You sure it was Rippers?
Jesus, Mike, yeah.
They're kind of hard to miss, you know, with the scars and acting crazy, killing anything that moves.
All right, just calm down. We got a parlay with Carlos. He gets us heading over to Iron Beard tomorrow. We'll find out what the hell's going on in that world.
We're sending...
Take John to Lost Lake Camp. Come back.
Deke, I hear you.
Mike.
Good. Look.
Boozer and I, we just had a run-in. Rippers, they...
Rippers? God damn it, you boys crossed the Iron Ridge? Deke, I told you!
Just listen. No, Mike. They were here, in Rogue Camp.
Rogue Camp? There were Rippers in Rogue Camp? You sure it was Rippers?
Jesus, Mike, yeah. They're kind of hard to miss, you know, with the scars and acting crazy, killing anything that moves.
All right, just calm down. We got a parlay with Carlos. This gets us heading over to Iron Butte tomorrow. We'll find out what the hell's going on in it.
You're sending Schizo to parlay with Carlos. Jesus, Mike.
Don't tell me how to run my camp, Deke. Like I said, my treaty is going to hold. Lost Lake out.
Hell, whatever you say, Mike. Whatever you say, Schizo's right. You're gonna get everyone killed. Ricky, I found her alive.
Deacon, thank God.
Look, she wouldn't come with me, so you gotta send someone who knows her, okay? She's on her way back to camp.
Okay. All right, okay. Ricky out.
You can say, John. Are you there?
Yeah, Mike. I'm here.
Get to a car.
Saving Gabby and all, I just wanted to thank you. I've known that little gal since she was in diapers.
Sure, Mike, yeah. I, just wish that I could have gotten to Abigail in time.
You did what you could. And I'm grateful. See you, Deke. Glad you're on our side. Mike out.
Hey, did someone pick her up?
Hey, Deke, yeah, she's fine. A little traumatized, but I guess no more than anyone else.
I guess we all know what it's like.
Yeah, I guess we do.
Yeah. See you, Ricky. Hey, Boozer, I'm heading up to Marion Forks.
Marion Forks? What the hell for?
As I decided... Hell, it's like you said, I've mourned her long enough. It's, time to say goodbye.
You heading to the church?
No. Yeah, maybe.
Oh, Jesus, Deke.
It's the last time, Boozer, I swear, Deacon out. Ricky, yeah. Okay, I'll be by. St. John out.
This is Radio Free Oregon.
thanks to the freaks. It doesn't belong to the feds either. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Once again, Cope, you don't know shit. Freaks ain't on anyone's side. And the world, yeah, already belongs to them. What the fuck?
Who's out there?
That's all you got?
That all you boys got?
Come on, come on, come on.
Stop it up.
You've each prepared your own vow? Well, traditionally, the groom goes first.
I'll go first. Deacon, I'm so sorry that no one came. I guess we really pissed off everyone on both sides.
I mean, not everyone.
But I want you to know that that's how much you mean to me. That I would give up anything for you. Anything. This ring is a symbol of my love. And it is precious. Has no beginning and no end. I love you.
of them.
What? Men
stay
coming!
Stay out of my church.
Oh, you like this, huh? Come on, Al!
This ring is my promise that I'm always going to love you, and I ain't ever going to leave you.
But you may kiss the bride.
Oh, wait a second. Here, you can have this one back, but only if you promise to ride me as much as you ride your bike.
Well, I now pronounce you man and, well, wife. Okay, I'm gonna just go. Get a room!
Boozman, you there?
Yeah, Deke, what's up?
You remember that little church? The one Sarah and I got married in? Well, I found a couple of assholes trashing the place.